Over in this area, we demolished the old coal tunnel. And now we're rehabbing the remaining parts of the building basement. As you can see, we have a pretty big excavation here. A lot of rock in this area that not always the easiest digging. This area here will be waterproofed and backfilled with an underdrain system into it to drain any water that gets under the surface, all connected into the new storm system that has different types of rain gardens and infiltration beds to be more conservation friendly with the stormwater runoff. Once this area gets waterproofed, it will be backfilled, and the new driveway actually goes right across the tunnel in the background. We're replacing the parapet walls from the demolition. The old coal tunnel, that used to be the driveway through here, it was a tunnel going through. Now that's going to be removed, so a little bit easier access. We have storm installed over on this other side over here. That will be a new outdoor STEM classroom. Science, technology, engineering, and math. It'll be a nice area for the students to, you know, kind of have a peaceful environment and make it maybe a little bit easier for their studies. This area here is going to be the new entrance to the high school. Behind me we have where it's going to be a future rain garden. That's an area where we'll dig out the existing soils and put in bio soils that are good for plant growth. It'll be a nice landscaped area. It'll be a nice entrance here, a lot different than the old entrance. When we started the project, the parking lot was about 20 feet above us here. After some earth moving and some regrading, now it's a lot more of a gradual slope and be a nice entrance to the high school. Today we're working on our sewer tie-in here in Olney Avenue, Philadelphia. We're about 18 feet deep, doing a modified saddle connection to an existing brick sewer line. We'll be tying in with our 18-inch ductile iron pipe and bringing it into the site to drain the site. We're continuing our work. Repairing the coal tunnel roof. We poured some concrete this morning on that, so that's moving right along. We have our excavation going for our new electric service. It's the main electric feed to the school that's getting buried into a new underground duct bank. And we're also installing some additional storm pipe to the upper parking lot. Once we get that in, then we'll be moving on to our grading and prep for paving, getting new curb in, and hopefully getting the site moving right along. Today on a project, we're moving along. We have here the excavations for our light pole bases that are going to be going in. This area here is going to be a new concrete walkway that'll be going down. It'll meet up at the bottom of the area over here where our steps are going in. We have our different slopes, steep slopes in these areas here that will be getting an application of a special stabilizing soil. This area that I'm walking down right now will be the ramp. There'll be some more drainage that needs to go in for the ramp down in here. We have the formwork going in now, and the footings are poured for the steps coming up. We'll be pouring the steps themselves and the landings here in the next few days. So quite a bit of work going on. We're continuing work on the coal tunnel over on the far side over here. Next to that, we have some more, some of our drainage pipes completed. We'll be putting in trench drains and other drainages into the courtyard area, and then be working out on from there to have our finished concrete work going in. So we finished up our curb installation last week and then have been grading our stone in this area over in here. Today we have the asphalt crew in, putting down their binder course of asphalt. The excavator in the background over here is excavating a rain garden. We'll dig that down to about 6 feet below finished grade, filling it back in with geofabric stone and biosoil. Down the bottom down here, we have some more grading going on for some additional asphalt that goes in at the STEM classroom area. On the other side of the coal tunnel, we're getting all the steel tied for our concrete pad that goes in on that side. Over here, we're mulching around the trees. They're going to be sitting for we don't know how long right now. And they usually fine for a week or so to sit out, but this may carry on longer than that. So we're gonna put mulch around them to keep them wet until we get back and can actually plant them in the ground. On the other side over here, we have guys putting down erosion control matting in order to stabilize all these slopes so that while we're gone, we don't have any erosion in any of the areas. These areas over here, we've hydroseeded them to, that's basically a grass seed that's in there. By the time we come back, we're probably gonna have grass growing over all these areas. So just trying to get everything stabilized before we leave today. Today on our project, we have all of our steep slopes are stabilized all along the side here. In the back, we have some more steep slopes that we're filling to grade and getting them ready for the benching and then the three layers of soil that are going on them. In the background over here, we raked and seeded our north lawn area. So hopefully the grass will be starting on that shortly. We have grass coming up all along all of our slopes. This here is one of our parking bays. It's a porous paving area that has, we excavated down to subgrades as designed on the plans, cover it with geofabric, and then place number 3 clean wash stone on top of it. It's to hold rainwater and slow down the release of the rainwater, hoping that some of it seeps back into the ground system. Anything that doesn't goes out the overflow and into the city storm sewer. So the project's moving along. We're right at the growing season now, so we're trying to get all of our trees and brush and plants and everything planted. Here's the concrete base for our elevated crosswalk. Concrete is reinforced with steel and poured thick because it's going to be getting a lot of traffic going across it. It will be covered with a layer of sand for leveling and then put down a herringbone pattern of asphalt pavers, which will give it a nice finished look. And it'll be our main entrance for anybody coming from the parking lot down into the building.
We did all the clearing and grubbing. We did all the earth moving. There was a tremendous amount of rock encountered. We had to hammer all the rock out. We installed all the storm, sanitary, and water piping. All of the utility tie-ins in the street, which were very deep, required engineered shoring. We hired multiple subcontractors to do the concrete walls, the concrete sidewalks, the landscaping. And we also have a special lift that's going in on the side of the building that BSI is installing for us. We've hired D'Andrea Brothers to do all of the walls and steps and scissor ramps on the project. And on one of the walls is going to be a very special emblem for Central High School. It's going to say CHS, and it's going to be beautiful.